Citizens of the Reject Nation, we got ourselves a Godzilla X Kong trailer today. How are you?
I'm pretty good. How are you?
I'm excited, man. Last night, my wife had the choice of what do we watch, and she chose Godzilla versus Kong. So I'm in a super big mood right now.
Kaiju-sized mood.
For Godzilla X Kong, the new empire. So you know what to do. Leave a like on this video, people. We got so much stuff coming out, so make sure to subscribe and click the notification bell. Enough chit-chat. Let's get to it.
Whoa. 2001.
Seismic activity.
Monarch, legacy of monsters.
Most of human civilization.
Egypt.
The wonders of the world.
That life could only exist on the surface of our planet.
Is that Rebecca Hall?
Sounds
this
like.
This looks like Transformers, true.
Yes. Revenge of the Fallen. He's got armor.
It looks like Transformers, yeah.
What else were we wrong about?
You wrong, Kong.
Oh.
Oh, you got that music back just like the last one.
Won't you come on in?
Yes!
There's more secrets.
Oh, they got new ships.
Yeah, they got anime ships.
She got short hair now.
What's that?
Still ripping you now and then.
Caesar. Oh, who's this little guy?
Oh, is that Kong?
Is that
Dan Stevens?
Kong.
The guest reunion.
Who could have done this?
I'm so excited.
It's personal. The rise of a partnership.
Wow.
Is that Gia? He's back!
Yes, my dude!
Kong can't stop this on his own.
He won't be alone.
Wow, the visuals are so much more improved.
Oh, wake him up!
That's my opinion. Is that a different
Thumb
creature
out.
Or is that Godzilla?
Whoa! What? What?
Damn.
Oh my goodness!
Ooh, damn, dude!
Holy balls!
Yeah, this looks wild.
Oh my god! This
they're
is gonna be the greatest movie of all
going,
time!
Buddy cops!
Welcome to my world.
Is that a mini Kong?
It's a set of Kong.
Oh my God. I am so jacked right now. I am excited.
But do you know what I'm most excited for? Them new Monarch suits that they got on, man.
Most definitely. Drips on those Monarch agents.
Look and fly is so important. Mm-hmm. And you know what, man? They could look even more fly this holiday season with some reject apparel at www.rejectnationshop.com, where you get shirts like this one of Pedro Pascal, Child Protection Services.
Look at that.
You can support just being a citizen of the Reject Nation with a real reject ticket stub shirt. But we also got Space Babies of the Galaxy. Who influences the influencers? Watchmen inspired. America's Ass Homelander shirt with a riff on Captain America. You know how it goes. And then we got Batverse. We got a whole bunch of other tees. And whatever you decide to get is a great way to support the channel. It's a great gift to get people for this holiday season. We make sure the shirts feel comfortable. And it's an excellent way to support the channel. My personal favorite way you can do it. All right, let's talk about this, man. Okay. Wow. All right. Well, I feel like Adam Wingard is the director?
Yes.
Yeah. I think Adam Wingard, you know, he got his feet wet with the last movie. I think he did an excellent job when it came to everything involving the Kaiju. And now after last night, I will have seen the last movie 3 times at this point. And I still think, like, man, he really excelled when it came to everything with the monsters, and especially bringing Kong a genuine personality and a character to connect with. And you can just tell that he's got a refined skill. I heard that there's going to be many sequences in this movie. One that might be up to close to 10 minutes where it's just going to be visuals of just the animation.
Yeah, all kaiju fights.
Just the monster. Just like scenes. Yeah. Like a scene, not even just a fight scene.
Okay, sure.
Because like the best parts of that movie are the scenes with Gia and Kong and Godzilla. Stuff that doesn't really have anything to do with the humans. You know?
Sure.
Outside of Gia.
She's the bridge between the humans that nobody cares about and the monsters.
Well, it looks like here that we're going to have... I heard that the name of the villain, and I could be wrong about this, I heard that the name of that ape villain is called Scar King.
Oh.
Okay. I could be wrong.
Stellan
Scar King. And that so he will be the main villain, and that he could have some type of other creature. That's about the extent of the rumors I've heard.
Sure.
This new ape monkey. So I feel like we'll have two different things here. It looks like we're going to have that bad guy to contend with that Kong finds in Hollow Earth, yes. Scar King, which we will need the aid of this evolved Godzilla with.
Yeah.
And then there's this other tribe, which I imagine by the end Kong would be like the leader, the ruler over the king. Yeah, that's it. Because he found a thing to be a king over. Where in Hollow Earth, the last movie, he just found a chair to sit on with an axe.
Yeah.
And now he's going to have people to rule.
My wardrobe and my accessories. Now I need my kingdom of subjects.
Wherever I go, this Godzilla wants to fight me.
Yeah.
Wherever I go.
We finally got peace, and now I need to reign over some people.
And then with an age of like having Monarch, Legacy of Monsters, with having Godzilla minus one, and then having this franchise to get an evolved Godzilla with a distinguished look, one that is very much distinguished, I think is a really smart call. But this just looks more like they're zeroing in and focusing in on everything that made the last movie work so well.
Yeah.
They're going to spend most of our time in the Hollow Earth. We're going to spend most of our time with the actual kaiju and creatures. The scale and threat level looks massive and epic. I really love Godzilla versus Kong. The only thing I don't really like is the Millie Bobby Brown and Brian Tyree Henry story. Outside of that, I know.
Shots
it's an unpopular opinion.
Nobody shares
I mean, I don't mind the Monarch characters, but the plot line I'm really not a big fan of.
Sure.
But everything else I really love. I think it's such a fun movie. and this, I imagine, will... While it's like a serious trailer, I feel like they'll probably go even... they'll lean into some of its more like strange wackiness that the last movie had.
Yeah. I mean, I have hope for that because I feel like Adam Wingard, of all the Monsterverse movies, managed to find like an agreeable tone mashup between, stuff that is like endearing and actually touching with Kong and Gia and that side of the story. But then, you know, bringing us the requisite sense of fun that Adam Wingard usually kind of has on his projects and stuff like that. And this seems like something where
it just
looks
so good, John. Look at the visuals.
That like fuchsia, glow in the backplates and stuff like that. And every Godzilla movie, there's always some kind of twist on the look and the power set and all that stuff and what it means when the atomic breath is especially so it's so hot now it's purple or something like that.
Just them running together while he's got his Thanos glove.
He's gonna snap half of the Hollow Earth.
So it must be something that Monarch helped design for him, I imagine. Or is it some type of ancient weapon that they used prior? Because it looks like something Monarch
might,
but it's
that
good.
Would get you closer to your Transformers crossover. Yeah. Some ancient tech.
I mean, he always needs some type of tech thing, right? But
he
it
got
shows
his axe last time, now he needs
it shows the threat
gauntlet.
Level for them to be for them to have to really partner up.
Yeah, no, 100%. After the uneasy alliance last time and the respectful kind of send off, but like the last movie had those. I'm curious about how much this is going to resemble some of the movies it's reminding me of, because the last one, obviously with Mechagodzilla and stuff like that, you have the whole like Batman v Superman element, and in this, I'm getting shades of like stuff that reminds me of both the early phases of 2001, but also moreover the recent like Planet of the Apes movies, where I'm like, is Kong gonna be dealing with some kind of like factional dispute that he needs to, yeah, like, you know, whoop this Scar King's ass to settle.
I mean, for Godzilla to get involved and to be teaming up with Kong,
it's gonna be an Earth threat.
Something tells me that the Scar King and Godzilla maybe have a
they got beef.
Yeah, that maybe there's a history with them.
They're gonna have a rap
because every the Kaiju all come from Hollow Earth. So maybe there is a history there that makes Godzilla be like, that son of a bitch is back.
I got to get in on the action.
He's going after my little monkey people.
My godson. Yeah. I like the look of Son of Kong, if that's who that is. I
think it's just another tribe.
Okay.
They don't look like Kong. I think it's going to become like, he's going to be like, again, I imagine it's going to be like surrogate because they don't look at all like they're the same type. Not all apes are the same.
Yeah, so I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be bigoted against Kong.
No, it looks like that's a completely different tribe, and then we're gonna see other members of this tribe.
Yeah,
and then Kong's gonna watch over them, and then it looks like too that there's elements here where you're gonna see Argea's people from the Hollow Earth as well, because you got all these like humans in a different civilization here as well. So
I'm
it looks like you're going to see that.
There must be, yeah, they must be the special people who live in whatever in Shang-Chi. You know, they live in. I keep wanting to call it Kunlun, but that's not the right property.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, maybe they are some kind of special race who are bonded with these creatures and you know, bound by duty to protect them or whatever.
But dudes, I love this trailer so much. I am so jacked.
I am jacked.
I really love this.
Yeah. No, absolutely. This has all the fun and like promise of wacky, you know, more broad expansions, and it's fascinating to see what we in America choose to do to up the ante, while, you know, you also have immediate examples of what Japan's doing to up the ante, and it's just a fun time to be a Godzilla fan, G.
Yeah, I agree, John. Guys, what'd you think about the trailer? Leave your thoughts down below. Be sure to subscribe. Leave a like. I gotta get this video delivered to all y'all. And support us at RejectNationShop.com. Let's get to it.